Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you an effective technique for retouching skin that retains the skin's texture while it removes skin blotches and imperfections. This technique is called frequency separation. Before we begin, if you enjoy my tutorials, show your support by becoming a patron to Blue Lightning TV. Go to patreon.com/BlueLightningTV, all one word, or simply click the link in this video's description, which is below the title of this video. Thanks! Open a photo of a face that you'd like to retouch. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The first step is to make two copies of the photo by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Name the top layer High Frequency Texture and the middle layer Low Frequency Blur. Click off the eyeball icon next to the top layer to temporarily hide it and go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Drag the slider until it blurs the skin just enough to hide most of the pores and blotchiness. Then click OK. Make the top layer visible and active. Go to Image and Apply Image. For the source layer, click Low Frequency Blur. And for the target blending mode, click Subtract. The scale is 2 and offset is 128. Then click OK. Change the blend mode to Linear Light. At this point, your photo will look exactly the same. Make the middle layer active. Zoom into areas of the face by pressing Z to open your zoom tool and drag it over the forehead. Open your lasso tool and draw a selection over the inside of the forehead. We'll feather it so its edges will be soft. For me, the best way to preview the amount of feathering is to click the Refine Edge button or go to Select and Refine Edge. Drag the feather slider to the right until the inside of the selection is blurred approximately this much. The actual pixel amount on yours may be very different than mine depending on your photo's size and resolution. Remember your pixel amount and click Cancel. At the top, in the feather field, type in that amount. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. To apply the feathering, draw another selection inside the forehead and go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Slide the blur radius to an amount that makes the blotchiness disappear. The texture remains because it's on a different layer. Click OK and deselect it. If you see some imperfections in the texture, we'll take care of them in a few minutes. Right now, we're just concerned with removing the blotchiness and overall inconsistencies. To reposition the face on your canvas, press and hold the space bar as you drag the image. Draw another selection around the cheek and make sure you don't get too close to the eyes, hair, lips, and neck. Press Ctrl or Command F to repeat the last filter you used, which was Gaussian Blur. Then delete the selection. Draw another selection around the other cheek, repeat the filter, and deselect it. I'll repeat these steps for the chin. Next, let's retouch the nose. Since the nose has more problems with texture than with blotchiness, we'll retouch its texture. To do this, make the high frequency texture layer active And this time, we'll use the clone stamp tool. Make sure the mode is normal, the flow is 100%, and the current layer is showing. Make its opacity approximately 35 to 40%. To make your stamp tool bigger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. We'll copy the texture of a smooth area of the skin and clone it onto the nose. To do this, Alt-click or Option-click on a smooth area of the skin to copy its texture, and brush over a small area of the nose to clone the texture onto it. Go back to the same smooth area, Alt-click or Option-click on it, and brush over another small area of the nose. Continue this until the entire nose is smooth. Remember, we're not cloning color nor brightness and contrast, we're only cloning texture. Let's retouch the neck of your subject. Drag the neck into view. Since the neck has problems mostly with skin blotchiness, I'll make the low frequency blur layer active and open my lasso tool again. I'll draw inside the neck and shoulder blades, avoiding getting too close to her clothing, chin, and hair. I'll repeat my last filter, which was Gaussian blur, and I'll deselect it. To fit your image back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. To see the before and after, Alt-click or Option-click on the eyeball icon next to the bottom layer to hide all the other layers. To make all the other layers visible again, Alt-click or Option-click on the eyeball icon again. If you want to finesse it more by removing tiny spots of texture imperfections, zoom into the area you want to finesse by pressing Ctrl or Command plus the plus key on your keyboard, and drag your subject to the area you want to finesse. Make your high-frequency texture layer active again. This time, we'll open the Spot Healing Brush. Make your brush a bit larger than the spot you want to remove, and simply click or brush over the spot. Continue to click or brush over other tiny texture imperfections until the entire face is flawless. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.